Vishwa Pranayar for giving me this opportunity to moderate this panel discussion. So we have amongst us Dr. Shiv Mohan and Dr. Markandoza. I'm really grateful to both of them for sparing time out on a Sunday to make it to this panel discussion. Reet and a couple of students, Dhaval, they kept following up. Having a panel of ISRO is really tough and also really a matter of great pride for us because ek kaam bahut hota hai. Unlike most government organizations, ISRO is one of the most performing and productive government organizations. Secondly, both of them, they are stalwarts in their fields. Dr. Shiv Mohan is the pioneer of microwave remote sensing. Both of them are from SAC ISRO, Space Application Center. Dr. Markandoza, I heard him in the month of December. That's when I first met him. Dr. Oza is a pioneer of geospatial technology at SAC ISRO in Ahmedabad. He is the person behind VEDAS, which is the archival system, Earth Observation Archival System. So both of them have had very crucial roles to play at ISRO and have evolved a wide range of technologies. And this is probably the most relevant thing for engineers today, because hamara jo engineering talent hai, nichod hai, uska direct application desh ke vikas mein ISRO mein ho raha hai. So it is very something that we should all look up to, and in the process kahin na kahin hum hamare jeevan mein bhi inse kuch seekh karke apply kar sake. That should be the objective. So mera zyada samay na lete hue, I'll ask Dr. Shiv Mohan and Dr. Markandoza to give their opening statements and what they feel about the future of the space industry, the future of ISRO for the next 5, 10, 20 years. Because aapko aur mereko ISRO ke baare mein sirf Akshay Kumar se maloom padta hai. So apart from that, kya ho raha hai is desh mein, ISRO mein? In that, I'd like sirs to give their most thoughtful ideas. And after that, we'll take up individual questions from sirs on how we can implement these small, at a very small level, the work that sirs are doing in the space industry. So, over to you, sir. So, Dr. Shiv Mohan, he is the core team member of Chandrayaan 1. Sir has written a book on Chandrayaan 1. Was also amongst the key players behind Chandrayaan 2 when it was initiated. Sir has spent a lifetime at ISRO. And is actively involved in a lot of academic research and otherwise activities at ISRO and at a lot of universities across India. So, sir, your opening remarks.
Okay, thank you. And thank you all for inviting us and interacting with such a beautiful set of people in front of us, which I cannot see because of darkness. But I understand the patience with which you may be listening to us. Now, if you look it towards ISRO, when I was traveling from airport to this place, hotel, and I understood few questions whether students, community would be interested to know about ISRO and other things. Space has today, if not only ISRO, globe, if you see, space is a sign of development of a country. That is what called space power in 57, who is space power? Soviet, Russia, and USA. India is now one of them among the 5 or 6 countries in the world. So it becomes an engine of the growth of the country. That means high technology, highest technology in the world. Because space instrument or space thing, anything, it's not a simple, it's a very high end. So it demonstrates the technology of the country. It demonstrates the technology of the people. Country means people, those who are staying there. Like ISRO, you look today. I came across the questions from few of you in a personal discussion. From which university you are? I said, we are from middle level institute. All of us ISRO people, we are not from IITs or ISC or some foreign countries. I am from AMU, from Gujarat University, and from some, you will find ISRO consisting of people from many of institutes which you may not be knowing. So one thing I just want to tell everybody that if those who have not got IITs, don't feel be afraid that you have lost a word. A lot of words, new words, technologies, they wait for you people to come up. Institute like ISRO, DRDO, they never look on the your educational qualification from which country, only they look, have you qualified my examination which I have called for, that's all, nothing else. So beyond that, as I said, space has become a sort of engine of growth of any country. Pakistan is backward. So when you compare the space, we will never be compared with Pakistan. We will always say we are among the Japan, China, Russia, this and that. So it's a sign of prosperity of technology, not of the people. I look back myself 30 years before, and in the beginning of my career, I was working in German Space Research Organization. And at that time, India first, satellite was launched in 78 or 77. And you know what German newspaper reported, a poor country is launching the satellite. And headline with a figure, still I remember, and a headline, an image of a person, of a boy, very poor boy, having a katora with no rotis. That I was really felt bad for the country. And but today I see it back. India is recognized one of the best nation in the space industry. We have payloads from Germany, and I am part of Venus mission payload selection. We have announced from where the payloads should come in addition to Indian payloads. We have 12 from India, remaining from rest of the world. We have 12 payloads from the NASA. 6 payloads from the same country which I remembered some just now. And all over the Europe. We don't have any payload from Pakistan, Bangladesh, this and that. So many small countries. So they're never counted. Nobody will ask that, no, we don't have any payloads. They will ask, oh, UK, we don't have any payload. Just re-examine. So only our country is compared with the comparables now. So that has the sense of, you can say, the upliftment of my country during last 30 years. Now this upliftment is further moved. You know, every time leadership changes in this row, 5 years, 10 years, new leader is coming up with a new idea. You have seen now present leader, he has no fear. He will call Prime Minister during our launch of Chandrayaan 2. He is confident this will go. It went up everything. Somehow, media showed it as a failure. And I told everybody, it's not a failure. Your mission has gone up to the extent where you wanted. In that mission, an orbiter is still collecting data. We have 6 payloads from our own countries. And first time, a unique data is being collected. And analysis of that is being reported in our ISRO website. You can always see it. Now, what has gone wrong to media? I have traveled from 100 kilometers from satellite, a smaller payload out of that, up to 98 kilometers. Last 2 kilometers, it could not, it crashed. That is the failure which has come as a headline, failure statement. So my thing is, everywhere I tell, it's not a failure, it's a success. 2%, 3%, 5%. I sent my child successfully, 98%, 2% he didn't reach, it's not a failure. It worked as per our command, 98% of that 100 kilometer, only 2 kilometer, it didn't listen to us. So, Again, I will repeating, it's nowhere a failure if one of the successful, but ISRO people, whatever they do, like our C1, he is so much attached to everything, and you feel sentimental when you are not able to achieve 100% success. Now we are the people looks for 100% success. 25 launches for this year. We have Chandrayaan 3 for this year. And many satellites which we built for the civilian, like recently hyperspectral, we had to give to defense because the priority is there. So next few years, we have number of launches with PSLV, GSLV, and small satellites from the foreign countries. And you will see here, in 2023, we will be the first in the world who will be launching maximum payload in the interplanetary missions in the Venus 2. And we are the first who will be going to Venus first time all over the globe, first time we are going. Now, our goals, thinking, everything is perfect in a sense, because ISRO has become too matured in developing the technology and implementing it. If I get a project of, suppose, 10 lakhs, I project a smaller amount, 10 lakhs is nothing. And has to be seen that strictly I complete that 10 lakhs. So it's a very strict monitoring. It's not just like university professor, if he doesn't do, okay, comfortable, next year we'll do. No, it has to be done as per the your plan, targets plan. In one meeting, Chandrayaan 2, we didn't get our some of the payload to be delivered. Then you see one said, he's our chairman, we are like now, this Indigo flights, it will go whether passenger comes or not. So with this kind of thing, we are working, and certainly it requires a lot of dedication. You have to be away from family. Many times your marriage anniversary or children birthday, or you are away from there. Now what has changed in the world? Our own. I went to one for printing my card to one shop. And he said that we don't charge for the designing charge, we don't take from the military people as well as ISRO people. So I became too sentimental that our own image had changed during last 30 years. So I was happy that, and only once it has happened, I airport to, I visit many places like this, and at airport, only once it has happened that security guard, he saw my card, okay, ISRO, sahab, ISRO, I just immediately salute to ISRO. So this has come through our own hard work, our own way of thinking, and our leaders who, like Abdul Kalam, he said, many such kind of leaders we got, and we are also trained in those directions. So ISRO has a bigger dream now. We'll talk on how you could come into that dream, how you could be part of that dream. And I now give to my colleagues, Oja sir, and then we will talk much more.
Okay. Hello. Dr. Shivmohan ne bahut satik tarike se bataya. To pehla mera observation hai, ISRO mein 3% se zyada IIT se nahi hai. And I'm one of those 3%, and I may not be performing better than others. Others are performing better than that. Agar mujhe puche USP ISRO ka kya hai, to it is teamwork rather than individual brilliance. We work in project mode, and the entire project get recognized, not a person leading or trailing in a project. So that is the USP of ISRO. Another thing, many of you may be feeling that ISRO is a big name, so only people with big name or institutional tag, they get into it. It is not true. Other thing is, even if you are, I mean, you see, somewhere we have to do gradation. So marks and grades and these things count. And many of aspiring young engineers and scientists, they think that ISRO is beyond us. We cannot learn or enter ISRO. So it is not like that. ISRO has many outreach programs. So one of them, I mean, many of them, where you have to tell, this is the problem. I will use data of space segment or the deliverable that I derive from my analysis can be linked to any of the ISRO's program. You are welcome to our ISRO to work for 3 months up to 1 year at no cost. We'll give you hardware, software, guidance, and what else. So opportunity is there for anybody, not necessarily as an employee, but as an analyst, and definitely whatever you knew, you design, develop, patent would remain with you. So that is the opportunity. This is how ISRO is moving. That is one thing I want to make. Another thing is, now ISRO is also a government organization. So we also have limitations or rules and regulations to follow. Okay, but still within those rules, we try to be autonomous or as free as possible. But it's not always possible, but that does not reflect on part of ISRO. So some of the work, I think can I start my presentation where I'll show something or little later?
You can, sir.
Yeah. Can I have my presentation, please? So basically what I'm trying to say is, Joy. I have kept title as Space for Everyone in Space Sector. Not necessarily academia, not necessarily ISRO, not for decision makers. It is even for people, it is for industry, it is for startups. So I'll try to convince or give flavor of why I feel so. Next. Okay. Now, the first statement of our founder father, Dr. Vikram Sarabhai, he says that many will question, like Dr. Shimon was telling, that when we launch, people were perfect. But space is for everyone. And if we have to be second to none in technology. So there is no sacrifice on technological front. However, our target remains applications, societal applications. So application drives us what should be the sensors, and that tells what should be the launcher. Now I'll tell you these 2-3 terms. They sound very hi-fi, but they are very simple. Sensor is a camera. Satellite is a house. If you have 2 BHK house, so similarly, my satellite can have 3 sensors, 5 sensors, multiple sensors. So, and launch vehicle. Now many times you'll be hearing that 50th launch of PSLV or 10th launch of GSLV. So what is this? So basically, PSLV, Polar Satellite Launch Vehicle, that means, roughly speaking, 2 tons of satellite weight into 800 kilometer of orbit, that is the capability of that vehicle. GSLV means 2 tons in 36,000 kilometer orbit. It's like telling that car is also a four-wheeler, truck is also a four-wheeler, but truck is required when I want to transport heavy materials and car for smaller. So depending upon weight, another challenge in satellite is we have to minimize or optimize weight, volume, and power requirement, because that controls. I am given particular space, it should not have certain value. Here I would like to tell story about one competition, global competition, which even in Asia it was there. It's called CANSAT. There, particularly for engineering, it will be very interesting. Their challenge is very simple. You are given a volume of a can like this. A can like this. 65 millimeter in diameter, 115 millimeter in height, and the payload or the satellite or sensor that you make should be less than 350 grams. If you make, ISRO will launch on a smaller orbit. After release from satellite,
it can inflate. So how compact, how lightweight, and how efficient a young student can build a payload. Now, this type of opportunity did not exist maybe 10 years back, certainly not when I entered ISRO. So ISRO is really trying to tap young talent by giving challenging problems. One of the interesting and recent development as far as India is concerned is Smart India Hackathon. I'm a fan of it. You see, what ISRO wants, we have listed hundreds of problems on internet. You can address any one of them. They will be scrutinized, a smaller set will be selected, and you are given 36 hours of non-stop programming coding to come out with a solution. Nobody will come out with a solution, but there we look for ingenuity of approach amongst the young technocrats. So from last year, I hear that hardware addition has also been added. So in 30, the problem is given 3 or 4 months in advance. In between, there will be one or two interactions, particularly related to confusion. What is expected, what is asked, and what are the limitations? You can ask and then deliver during live, and during those live 36 hours of this thing, our mentors would be visiting, squeezing, asking you additional add-on questions, asking you to address challenging problems. We are trying to harness young talent. So that is one thing. So having said that, okay, so I think I have talked about launchers there.
Thank you so much, sir, for that wonderful presentation and for those insights. So a lot of things we got to know. That one, ISRO is also open to encouraging a lot of youngsters in the hackathon format, and also the hands-on training that sir mentioned, 3 months to 1 year, the format. So these are some amazing things that we have learned today. Ye mujhe bhi nahi pata tha. These are things that we can all take part of, especially aapka generation abhi, since you are all studying, you should actively make use of all these formats. Just like hum tech space mein kehte hain ki Facebook ka F8 conference hua ya Apple ka worldwide developers conference hua, ye hamare desh ke sarvochch institution ke kuch is tarah ke programs hai outreach format ke, and is tarah ki cheeze hum sab hame purzor tarah se karna chahiye. So there was one point that we wanted to touch upon was the privatization of the space industry. So kyunki privatization aajkal kafi hone laga hai, especially with the influx of an organization such as SpaceX, jo Elon Musk ne kafi shiddat se banaya hai. So with organizations such as that, what is the future of privatization of the space industry in the specific context of India? Kya hum aane wale kuch saalon mein is tarah ka kuch progress dekh sakte hain? And if yes, then we have such great people amongst us. So can we think of a startup? Yani, every entrepreneurship summit should be objective oriented. Otherwise, hum sab hasi khushi aate, khana khate hain, taali bajate hain, seeti bajate hain, and ghar chale jate hain. So in that process, why not announce on this Vishwapreneur 2020 platform that aapke college se ya aas paas ke colleges se aaye students se kahin se koi ek space sector ka startup shuru kare, is tarah ki possibilities ho sakti hain, usme sirs ka mentorship mil sakta hai, and kya kuch kiya ja sakta hai. So sir, your remarks about the privatization of the space industry globally and in India.
Few days before 1st Feb, our finance minister Nirmala Sitaraman, she announced a budget of 13,474 crores for ISRO, which is merely 7.5% more than last year, but about 45% more than 2014-15. This is in addition to 10,000 crore for Gaganyaan project, something around 13,000 crore for 20 GSLB and PSLB launches. So this much of money when it comes to bigger, and this is in addition to money which I am not counted for Defense Space Research Organization, which is silent there. So that is also exploring equally space segment, which we are not talking at the moment. But I know because I do teach there also. So, and ISRO has last year set up one small, that's name is something, New Space India Limited, NSUL. Then last year 10 crore was allocated for this, and this year it was silent. So we should just find out what is that. But one thing is that money, when it is open kind of money and bigger dreams of the country, that means ISRO is looking towards that, it cannot be fulfilled. ISRO cannot do 25 launches. It could do 6 launches of PSLV. So they have to depend on private organization. Now, the two kind of private sector, one which builds the satellite, one which builds the rocket, one which is platform based, like morning he talked. That means you develop applications using this data, which can go to many kind of users, like the crop insurance, agriculture sector, then eco environment, and so many things are there which directly uses this data set, where the investment are less. But in the upper crest of that means satellite and you can say rockets, investment could be more. Now, seeing the present scenario, the some of the companies are being mentored by ISRO, like L&T, we get some motor for SLV and other launches. There are few others which are under the mentorship of ISRO, and few are open for the ISRO to mentor them, provide the support to ISRO in return for those kind of programs. At the same time, now ISRO is also looking towards a small launch vehicle, which is cost about 30 to 50 crores. Cost is not much, 30, 40 crores, of the which is able to launch a satellite of 500 kilogram. So one company, two companies, I think, working Beltrex in Bombay, and one is in, I think, Quas or something, in one Bangalore, one is Bombay. And they have come out with certain things. Now, when you develop these things, you need a lot of sub-industries. Means you need electronics component, you have to import, you need many mechanical components. So there will be many sub-industries who have to support this one industry who is making the. So the target could be, let the first bigger one to establish and smaller one automatically grows around that. For that investor, they have to open their coffer, but they are not doing, because they also don't have confidence that they would be able to get back the money, or the gestation period could be much higher, because it's a competitive all over the world. Now, third issue is, when we go for such kind of bigger thing, the government bill, whether government has to pass a bill which allows people to launch the vehicle. You cannot launch anything in this country. Rockets you cannot launch. So there could be bill what kind of rockets you can launch, and clarity on that. So all those happens, but technically we should be ready to do all those things once our bill passes. Bill has to pass. It's not that it will not pass, but that readiness for making that thing, I think presently only 2 or 3 companies are working. But there is a much bigger scope if you go for kind of, even in the satellite launch or satellite building, all the time help is available from ISRO side, that will support you technically, because today countries that you can say the high-tech area people are less. Relatively, ISRO provides up to a limit, but those who are retired, many will be available, and one should use those retired community, and it will be certainly possible to help many youngsters and where they can work as a mentor for the various projects. And I am working on a platform which is a sort of NGO will be there, where I'm collecting CV of many retired people and putting in our network. So any youngsters want, I would be able to tell, okay, you contact this person. Today I don't know who is asking something, who is not asking, and who could be a person who could mentor some kind of project. So that kind of relationship develops when you have some sort of platform which gives all those information to anybody. So that is a must, because it's a not individual idea, it's a bigger idea which involves a lot of expertise in all the fields. Third is where the market has much more, where the India has done obviously much more is in the IT utilization of data, which is a mainly IT related problems. And many industries, I think at the moment around 300 industries are working on that. There also, what they have done, they have collected recruited people from data science, because triple IT, IT, everywhere they say data science, they will do everything in the world. They recruited, and now when they started analyzing the satellite data, problem was that person didn't understand how that mechanism, physical process by which the data has come. You cannot just put everything into some classes. So you need, again, specialized knowledge. So in fact, that idea has, because I interacted with those set of people, then that idea came to my mind, why don't I establish something, a linkage, so that a industry need not to hire all the time, he can hire for a temporary period from this lot which I will have. So that's some thought. It's not that it's the end of the process. We have to encourage youngsters to come forward. Recently, somebody from Pune, he is having a lot of knowledge on a startup on AI and other things. He want to create soil moisture map, and he was in touch with me. Then I said, no problem, we can work together and create a sort of output from the satellite images. So ideas are coming from youngsters. Only thing is they are not getting the right kind of mentor at the moment. So idea of establishing a mentor could be from this institute also, a forum for a mentor, which will help you to do some of the tasks which you find probably difficult to it. So privatization means number of things. As I said, you need expert, that means mentors. You need fund, investors have to open their coffer, because still they don't have a confidence in that. Because you may have MOU with ISRO, but ISRO may or may not be able to support at that time, because they have their own target. So you have to come out with an independent way. And obviously, among many, because when I look back, all these interacted with all these kind of thing, I found third, where it's an involvement of application of IT. Investment is less, returns are much more. Could be the initial point where industries can play, and many industries are already in the market now doing that kind of job. You know, they're getting funding from Niti Aayog, from DST, from here, state government, then state disaster management system, lot of applications, like even the our startup can go, give the idea to them and get some funding for 2 or 3 years. So these are some of the points where the privatization is required. And then second thing is infrastructure and quality of that infrastructure. ISRO is setting infrastructure for satellite building launch in the Trivandrum. It may take, I think, 2 or 3 years. And quality of that infrastructure is a must, because that's why ISRO has put their leg, that infrastructure is required. And it has to be world-class infrastructure for developing a good system, good satellite or good launch vehicle. So with this, there are limitations at the moment. I don't see immediately the growth it will happen. But it is certainly going to happen in 4 or 5 years, a better platform. better way of learning, and more now India is on the third, I think, in doing the ease of business. So which is already existing, but the frame has to be more for the space technology. Bill has to be enacted. Everybody cannot launch still a satellite. They have to take permissions. So all those have to be cleared. Then our things are cleared for the privatization of the space industry, and countries develop much more. What he does, he repeats the same thing what his parents are doing. So when I joined ISRO, I went from university, state to government department. My bosses used to work, my office timings were in 78. I think 9 o'clock to 5 o'clock is my office time. And we were, most of them, I think that time people were young, only few seniors people, those who were transported from TIFR or some educational institute. So he used to sit from 9 a.m. and till 8 p.m., my boss.
Yeah.
And we came from university, you know, PhD doing, you will go 10 times to coffee house in a day. फिर रात को काम कर रहे हैं, फिर 11 बजे फिर कॉफ़ी हाउस. आई सो दिस पर्सन यार, ही 9 बजे आके 8 बजे उठता है. सो वी लर्न, दैट्स व्हाट आई सेड, फ्रॉम हूम वी लर्न, वी सी फ्रॉम आवर आईज, दैट दीज आर द पीपल. एंड ही विल नेवर लाइक टू बैंग अस, फॉर्चुनेटली, दैट व्हाई यू आर वेयर यू डिसअपीयर्ड, ओनली वर्क, दिस वाज व्हाट हैज हैपेंड एंड ऑल दोस काइंड ऑफ थिंग happens in the while you do a work. And you learn, you also start sitting for more time. When you are sitting, you will not sleep, no? You'll also produce something.
Yeah.
When you are young, you'll also, and not only that, to that time, today also, all youngsters want to perform something. So when we enter, we also want to do something. But you don't know what and how. So boss will tell, because we were in learning phase, boss also learning phase, we are also, he says something we have to do on microwave, how signal comes, how it goes, that you have to find out yourself. So we learn from that okay, I have to do myself. Boss will give limited guidance. Then we started learning slowly things, and in the process what happens, you also become of that type, you also start sitting working for more time, and this culture continues. So you get the culture from the your own institute. Within institute, there will be variability. One boss may be different. That is a different issue. But overall, results are, now importance is, as a private, we work also as a private. Suppose I am not obeying, I am not able to do something performing. I may be removed, all my facilities may be removed. I'm always afraid that whatever I have grown, it can go in a minute to somebody else if I don't perform. So that fear is there. So, but at the same time, you have to keep your team along with you. Because if you are at a middle management, you have to, your team also along with you, and your boss has to along with you. So it has to be aligned, and everything over a period of time, everybody learns to be aligned with the system and they perform. For example, if I take a project from anything, suppose I'm application scientist, so application development, I ask for 20 crores or 30 crores for doing that, I will be getting, okay, not straightforward. When I joined ISRO, they will ask, question when I project my, that I want to do this XYZ, question will be, okay, what you have projected is okay. Has anybody done in this world? I'll say, sir, so and so has done in 74, so and so, so I am doing excellent. Now when I retired in 2011, has anybody done in this world? I have to tell, no, nobody has done, I'm the first. So we ourselves have become stronger and stronger in our own domain. And that becomes because we start working and that culture exists over the years, from generation to generation, people do work. And at the same time, because we have to work in the team, so that culture exists there. And we have to do the things in time that culture exists, because, for example, my budget meeting, I'm responsible for the using budget. Suppose out of 1 lakh, 1 rupee I don't spend, I'm responsible. But in that meeting, all are invited, all my co-PI or my... So even the clerk is invited, and it happens at a bigger level. I will say, sir, this fellow has not signed my file. So responsibilities are with everybody. It's not one. So everybody is responsible why that 1 rupee was not spent. That is why you will get zero unspent balance from ISRO. Other organization always, they 50% lapses.
Yeah.
So that difference exists. Targets are monitored from top to bottom. As I said, that chairman will tell, okay, it's like Indigo, PSL will go, don't bring your payload. I don't want your payload. So it's a threat to you. And you will try to bring payload, whatever condition, little degraded, okay, chairman is accepting. Suppose quality is not maintained of that, then you are banked for that also. It's not you are free from that. So strict vigilance on the activity of the people is important, and which is missing in government department. Baki mein aap jab theek hai, okay, it does the work. If you don't do it, it does. Our thing, if you don't do it, you get away from that. We have 5% people, 1% people, they may not have, but they become also frustrated with because they don't have a work. Yeah. So that's a culture, it's different.
Thank you so much, sir. Sir, aapse bhi wahi sawal, since abhi aap current employee hain SAC ISRO mein, aisi kaun se pointers hain jinke karan ISRO is what it is today? जो कि और जैसा कि सर को भी सुना, ऐसी कई सारी चीज़ें हैं जो हम हमारे लाइफ में भी अप्लाई कर सकते हैं. फ्रॉम द फैक्ट दैट देर इज़ ट्रांसपेरेंसी इन टर्म्स ऑफ फंड यूटिलाइजेशन, देर इज़ अ वेरी स्ट्रक्चर्ड रिपोर्टिंग फॉर्मेट. पीपल आर ऑल वर्कोहॉलिक, दे आर लॉगिंग इन आवर्स, समटाइम्स मोर आवर्स देन इट इज़ रिक्वायर्ड टू एनश्योर रिजल्ट आर गुड, बिकॉज द डेवलपमेंट इंडेक्स ऑफ आवर नेशन is relying upon the work that they are doing. So it is not a loan application that needs to be passed aur uske liye logon ko lunch break ke baad aana bol ke choda ja sakta hai, right? So these are all work ethics, ethos and values that all of us can apply in our lives. So yehi sari values hain which I think ISRO ko what it is today banaya hai. Sir, aap bataen.
वर्क कल्चर बोलूंगा तो हमारा वर्क कल्चर से ज्यादा टारगेट कल्चर है.
yeah.
कि दिस एक्टिविटी रिक्वायर्स से 60 आवर्स ऑफ मैन मंथ, सो यू हैव टू कंप्लीट इन दोस मेनी डेज. इफ यू रिक्वायर देन यू कम ऑन सैटरडे संडे, स्टे बियॉन्ड एट दैट टाइम, अनलेस देर इज व्हाट आई से फिजिकल लिमिटिंग फैक्टर लाइक इलनेस, वी आर नॉट स्पेयर्ड. I will not be spared from my higher ups. I cannot afford to spare my people who work with me.
Yeah.
Other thing is, though I say that it is teamwork, or only chairman and few top people are able to take credit or make announcement.
Yeah.
Internally, we do recognize teams and individual excellence.
Individuals.
So every year, about 50 to 100 scientists or engineers, no number is fixed, you should have made impactful and optimized contribution to space sector, whatever, be it application, be it sensor development, be it communication, then they are recognized internally. But so you see, without internal recognition, motivation has to be there. So it is there, but to public only one or two spokesmen, so that there are less contradictions and there are less distraction from media, particularly electronic. So this is the work culture. It is based on assessed targets. It's not that you say 100 hours. I will also say it doesn't require 100 hours. You should be able to complete in 80 hours. Now, so 80 hours. So if you are not able to complete in 5 days, you and if you think 100, so compensate you by coming on holidays. So it's more like that. But we are also compassionate.
Compassionate.
We also give time, and ISRO has a very good culture even of sports. Every year there will be internal ISRO
center competition, next year outdoor.
Yeah.
So every alternate year, all ISRO centers meet for 2 weeks, play, enjoy, compete, even in this sector. So culture is very good, compassionate, but demanding.
So thank you so much, sir, for that wonderful insight. जैसा कि आप सबने भी सुना, we are unnecessarily chasing bigger organizations based out of India, whereas such great organizations exist within India, which are producing great results. Yet कहीं ना कहीं the value system is so good that जो individual heroes हैं उस organization के, they never take full credit in media. Which is great because आज का generation जो हो गया है, whether entrepreneurship देखें, it's all about a PR culture, right? अभी हम हमारे प्रधानमंत्री को ही देखें, जब वो फोटो रिलीज हुआ था, माताजी बैठ के टीवी पे देख रही हैं उन्हें प्रधानमंत्री बनते हुए, वो प्यार था कि PR था हम समझ नहीं पाए, right? So इस तरह की चीजें बहुत ज़्यादा हो गई हैं हमारे देश में, and at that time there is an organization that is breaking this norm and yet performing to such great extent. ये हमें सीखने में और हमारे लाइफ में इम्प्लीमेंट करने में बहुत ज़्यादा सहायता देगा. एंड एट द सेम टाइम, नाउ दैट वी आर ऑल्सो इम्प्रेस्ड, इट ब्रिंग्स मी टू वन ऑफ द फाइनल क्वेश्चंस कि सर अप्लाई कैसे करें, जो कि हर बंदा हर बार हर कॉन्फ्रेंस के बाद पूछता है, इंटर्नशिप या नौकरी, हम अप्लाई कैसे करें? सो इन योर एक्सपीरियंस, how do you suggest, what are the areas that VIIT students and the conference attendees should focus on in order to get a job at ISRO, and in the bigger picture, how can they see a future for themselves at ISRO? And also maths se jo dar lagta hai use jaane dena padega, because a lot of work that ISRO does is on mathematical modeling and algorithms.
This is maths PhD.
Yeah.
See, now, if you look for ISRO as a career option, we were talking at lunchtime also.
Yeah.
Space science as a, or aerospace as a career option. See, you have to look the where you are staying, which country you are staying. My country doesn't allow my dream to be fulfilled.
Yeah.
Okay, that is the, you start with, you want to become a space scientist, but you may get job in banks, or you may become the Indian administrative officer or somewhere, IAS or GPS or somewhere else. If you are trying for IAS, you may become ISRO scientist. So a dream has to be little broadened, otherwise it creates frustration. Number two, for getting some, I may have dream, okay, I want to do, like we never in our age, we never thought of dream, whichever job come first, that is my dream.
Yeah.
So applied ISRO, I got first, I got, this is my dream. Yeah. So that thing that, now once I enter ISRO, I being physicist, doing some soil sample collect, it's a rather different, I could not digest, but that itself become my dream. Okay, I will make a soil moisture map of the country, first time I did.
Yeah.
So dream is one where you have been put. You have been put in the ISRO, if you have been put in some other L&T or some bigger companies, that is your dream to build all those things. So first you have got a platform where you have to work. Now ISRO business is today much more open than yesterday. President Sivan has made, you want to understand many things, like he just now presented, open opportunities. As a learner you can go internship, PRL provides, ISRO provides free training, free data set, free software, everything you can go and learn. For getting employment, the open opportunities through IIST, you, after 12th you can directly apply for those. If you get admission, then job is guaranteed, but you have to have a 5 years something contract with them that you won't leave for then. But IIST education is nearly free of cost, not much. Now, suppose you are not able to get even those. ISRO provides opportunities to education institute like your own institute. You can submit a proposal to ISRO under RESPOND or many other scheme. Take a project which you want to do it, and you can get funding from them. And if there's a possibility always that ISRO provides, mostly they will never say no for good projects. So if you have anything, whether hardware, software, or application, anything is there, it's open to all. Now, some of my students, I will tell the story of them. They had a clear-cut dream, I want to do in planetary science only. For example, fix, I don't want to change. For them, the path was little longer. I told, you have done your M.Tech in geomatics. Now you take admission in UK in planetary science. But their post-graduation is 1 year course in UK. So she took admission 1 year there, and after that immediately she got a PhD admission in some European university, and the gate is open to what? More opportunities do exist globally in this kind of subject, because there the people are not going in this, in comparing to our country, everybody now want to do this now. Many, suppose you get a job, suppose you are getting a job. It doesn't mean everybody is launching the satellite. You may be doing soldering work, some small job. So never be frustrated. You may become frustrated, earlier, I thought this and I became soldering person. So that is the thing one has to leave. You have to, so different kind of thing. People come with a lot of imagination. And they become frustrated. Yaar, main toh usme keel laga raha hoon. So you have to be very clear. What are those people? What these are people? ISRO people? What they are doing? Everybody is not launching the satellite or making the satellite. There are different jobs. You have to many entry points as far as ISRO is concerned. After 12th, directly recruitment through universities and a training program. Through various means, they also do various training programs from through Indian Institute of Remote Sensing. They conduct a training program. They do the 2 years course in M.Tech also. You can get through them. So these are some of the ways you can get into ISRO. And openly, if you want to, some of the industries, those who are having projects with ISRO. There also you can go and explore the potential, and because ISRO is give mentorship. So you come to ISRO, use their facility, go back to industry. That's also option available. And last and least, not for you. First should be there, you start your own setup and come to ISRO that I will do this job for you. So that's for you.
Yeah. So thank you so much, sir. That was very inspiring. दो तीन चीजें जो मैंने भी देखा कि यही है that ISRO में काम करने वाला हर आदमी नील आर्मस्ट्रॉन्ग या कल्पना चावला नहीं बन रहा है, right? बूंद बूंद से बनता है सागर. सब अपना अपना रोल प्ले कर रहे हैं, and that is what leads to a bigger thing. Also the fact that किसी का भी, जैसे सर भी हैं, सपना नहीं था कि हम ISRO में ही काम करेंगे. Like sir said, it was very humble of him that apply kiya, mil gaya, and that's how it shaped into a career. So always remember, if you are confused, I was more confused than you are when you, I was your age, or so were sirs. It was just that kisi ka bhi koi bahut clear passion ya vision nahi hota hai. Ek direction pakad ke uspe kaam karne lag jao, apne aap it shapes into a career for a lot of us. So usi points ke saath sir, aapka bhi closing remarks as to how people can apply.
Yeah. I'll start from where Dr. Shiv Mohan ended.
Yeah.
Okay. There's a lot of, now ISRO has started incubation centers at 6 NIITs.
Wow.
So if you are aspiring, you can showcase your talent using infrastructure developed at NIITs, where it is called incubation centers.
Incubation.
This is besides space technology cells, which is available at few IITs.
IITs, yeah.
So it is not necessary that you be part of ISRO. Even without being part of ISRO, you can contribute to ISRO. Show your talent, definitely people recognize and they will absorb you. Don't ask, you will be demanded. So yeah. This is one thing. Other thing is that ISRO also has limitations of taking number of people.
Yeah.
But ISRO-related activities, that means space-related activities.
Yeah.
It could be even in service sector, software development, cloud computing, AI, deep learning. And one of the websites which I want each one of you to visit is vedas.sec.gov.in. You'll find various applications ranging from desertification process studies, new and renewable energy, agriculture, urban growth, polar science, all using basically space data. So similarly, so aim is that if you want to go into ISRO, that should not be the goal. You should be, I think most of the time our goal is to contribute to the national development. And you may be thinking this is one of the ways to contribute, and there are different ways even in space sector where I, as I told you, industry demands high tech engineers who can perform precise and specified technical task, and it's not easy to get quality product all the time consistently. So there are various ways without being directly in ISRO you can work for growth of space sector in India.
In India, yeah.
Thank you.
From the allied industries. So perfect. So thank you so much for your remarks.